This is the AnyCubic Photon Mono M5S. And in this video, I'm going to share 5 reasons that it's one of the most cutting-edge consumer resin printers on the market today. Let's dive in. First things first, a little background, and let's get the disclaimers out of the way. This unit was provided for free for review so that I could assess the quality of AnyCubic's products and service before accepting them as a sponsor. Additionally, this video is sponsored by AnyCubic. They haven't had any creative control whatsoever or seen this video before any of you have, and the opinions in this video are my own, but I, of course, can't call this a product review because money has changed hands here. So think of it as more like an overview. Look, guys, I tried to pay my landlord in 3D printers and it went almost exactly as you think. With all that said, I have to say that like my contemporaries Joel Telling and Uncle Jesse, I've been seriously impressed with this printer. And in a lot of ways, it's been a redeeming experience for resin 3D printing as a whole. Many of you, though, not that many because the video overall seems to have bombed, might remember that I recently tried resin 3D printing out for the first time, and while I was all cheery and optimistic when I first recorded the video, I had plenty of spills and horror stories by the time the video actually went into editing. So as you can imagine, I was a little bit wary when this big boy of a resin 3D printer showed up on my doorstep. Especially given that, unlike the model that I tested in my previous video, this is not marketed as a beginner's unit, but rather serves as the new top of the line for AnyCubic, coming in at a pretty respectable $499. Now that might not seem like a lot if you're an FDM person like me, but with many of AnyCubic's models selling for $189 to $299, this model is actually quite far out there in terms of price range. But here are some reasons why that price just might be justified. Whether or not you're into resin 3D printing, you've probably seen a lot of ads out there for 8K resin 3D printers. As I understand it, some of that is a bit misleading because what really matters is the pixel density on the screen. That is, resolution divided by area. But with this printer, you're not only getting a pretty large 10.1-inch display, you're also getting an industry-first 11,520 by 5,120 pixel display. That means that despite its relatively large size compared to other resin 3D printers, you are not compromising on resolution. And so far from my testing, that has definitely been true. One of the features that I didn't anticipate with this printer was the ridiculously fast speeds. Now, keep in mind, I don't know much about what's available on the market in the resin scene besides the printers that AnyCubic has sent me, but I was surprised to see that even Uncle Jesse, who I consider to be really quite an expert on all things resin 3D printing, called this the fastest resin printer he'd ever used. And let me tell you, it really is fast. They accomplish this in a few different ways. First, they use a special high-speed release film that allows you to peel off new layers way faster, like 1 second fast. Second, they use a special high-speed resin that has a viscosity closer to water than the usual goopy resin. Side note, it also has way less of a god-awful toxic smell to it than the stuff that I was using before, so that's much appreciated. Third, they have the default profiles for this set to 0.1 millimeters, which although it might seem tiny for us FDM folks, is really big in resin 3D printing. Now, I will admit you can barely see it in most of the models because the details are otherwise so very crisp. And it essentially means that you can print a staggering 105 millimeters per hour. I mean, just look at these models and the times they took to print. I'll put them up on the screen for you. Oh, and while you're admiring these models, check out this awesome model that my friend over at Printed Obsession made of me. So if you guys want to check out some of his other hideous monsters that he's created, make sure to check out his Patreon, which I'll link in the description. Here's another cool one, which given my limited experience with resin, if I hadn't seen Uncle Jesse talk about it, I probably wouldn't realize that it's such a big deal. In the FDM world, we're very much used to things like automatic bed leveling, but as it turns out, in consumer resin printing, this is a truly unique feature. If you remember back to my last foray into resin, I had a lot of prints, including my first few prints, fail because of improper bed leveling. So for this printer to do that every time out of the box is pretty sweet. And yes, it actually works. When I first wrote this script, I could say that I had yet to have a single print fail on this printer, but of course I knew and even wrote it into the script that if I write it in the script, a print would fail. And yes, today I had my first print fail. I'm learning. I'm really learning to predict those failures and stop writing in the script that I had no failures. So when you boot this thing up, it does all kinds of automatic checks, and that's really cool. But here's another head scratcher for you guys. AnyCubic claims that this printer can detect whether or not there is enough resin in the vat to complete the print. Okay, fine. So it probably has some kind of scale or load sensor in there, right? But get this. It can also detect if there are print failures mid-print. I guess maybe by sensing if the weight in the vat increases abruptly during printing, or if it's not decreasing at the predicted rate with resin getting cured and lifted out of the vat. I will say that the one print failure that I have had so far, it did not detect that there was a failure, or at least not until I stopped it. So I haven't been able to actually test if that feature works, or maybe I was just impatient in stopping the print. Ultimately, I don't know how this print failure detection works, but I have to say that if it does work, this is a very welcome feature, especially because unlike many FDM printers today, resin 3D printers don't typically have an integrated camera watching the print so that you can check in and stop things if they are looking funky, which actually is a great segue into my next point. One of the things that was missing for me in the beginner model that I tried out in my last resin video was the ability to transmit files directly to the printer, either over Wi-Fi and the LAN or a cloud service. I know, you guys hate cloud services, but for me, putting all the files onto a USB stick and then going into the room was a real pain in the neck because it would inevitably get resin on it, and then I didn't want to handle it without gloves, but I also don't want to get resin-soaked gloves anywhere near my MacBook, so, like, what do? Put one glove on, or take... I don't know. Fortunately, this printer has Wi-Fi connectivity and works through AnyCubic's own cloud service, which, although it's really... I mean, really slow for some reason, is available via a smartphone app or the desktop slicer. Now, I didn't get to check this out fully because this model is pre-release and isn't perfectly integrated with the cloud service, but I was able to get it loaded and working on my phone, and it was really convenient. Which leads me to... I'll be honest and say that when I started using the AnyCubic slicer instead of the paid options out there like ChuChuBox or Lychee that everyone recommends, I was a little embarrassed. But hear me out. This slicer is actually really, really good and really useful, and I'm not the only one who thinks so. AnyCubic has put a good amount of work into making it advanced for advanced users and simple for simpletons like me. Plus, they've added an intelligent mode which does all kinds of advanced tweaks to improve your prints. Plus, they have all the profiles for their printers and resins in there, which is super convenient. Kind of like using Prusa Slicer for your Prusa printer printing Prusament. By the way, speaking of Prusa Slicer, I am specifically talking about their resin slicer and not their FDM slicer, and I'm not going to comment on the whole controversy that's going on between them and Prusa. Hopefully it works out. I don't want to mention it in this video, but I did want to make it very clear. I am talking and complimenting about their resin slicer. So, yeah. I really like their resin slicer, and I'm gonna keep using it, damn it. So, what can I say? I really like this printer, and no, they're not paying me to say that part. I actually, genuinely, really like using it. Whereas, after publishing my last video, I had some significant, shall we say, mishaps that made me question whether or not I really want to keep learning and going down the resin 3D printing rabbit hole. This printer has made me excited to go back down that rabbit hole and continue my journey. It kind of just works, except for the print failure that I did have, which I'm pretty sure is because I didn't support the model correctly. So probably user error on that. And while it can't mitigate the pain in the butt parts of the resin printing process, like dealing with uncured resin, it makes all the other stuff, like slicing files, printing at high quality, sending things to the printer, and detecting failures, as simple as they can be. Truthfully, this printer is a little bit like the Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, in that it makes me ask, is it still the right call to recommend that beginners start out with a lower quality printer with less intelligence and fewer features? I mean, do beginners still need to go through that educational rite of passage of learning how the printer works by repairing it? Or are we on the brink of a new era of it just works printers, such that we should instead just recommend that beginners in the hobby go straight for these smarter, more advanced machines if their budget allows for it, because they're not gonna need to repair them? Let me know what you think in the comments below. And of course, if you want to support the channel, check out the referral links in the description to AnyCubic or any other 3D printing product that you're looking to pick up. It really does make a difference for the channel. Thanks once again to AnyCubic for sponsoring this video. Thank you to my Patreon supporters for your continued support. And thanks to all of you for watching, liking, and commenting. I'm gonna go print out some more fun resin models, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.